I mean, from an evolutionary standpoint, the two primary uses of unpleasant states of consciousness are, first of all, to paralyze, to essentially, how does, evolution get you to not move, to just like be quiet, essentially, either whether it is like panic or whether it is just intense pain, just kind of like just to not move. Evolution figured out, yeah, hey, like, yeah, intense pain, intense depressions can do that. And then the other very big role that suffering plays from an evolutionary standpoint is to rush your decisions. And yes, there are, some contexts where you could say that, well, there's a fire, you have to make a decision right now. There's a big disaster, you have to act right now. And from that point of view, yes, you could say that negative states of consciousness could be quite adaptive. But ideally, if we actually have the capacity to continue to move forward, interact with the world, there isn't kind of like a deep danger out there. And on top of that, we have the time to make our decisions properly, then I really don't see why, adding a depression on top of your decision-making process, like, really is going to help in any way, or like adding intense anxiety is really going to help in any way. There's like a little caveat here, which is that being acquainted with suffering does allow you to empathize a little bit better with other people who also have suffered. However, if you think about it, the reason why that matters is because then you can help them better, right? So in a hypothetical future where there's actually just no more suffering at all, there really wouldn't be a reason to reintroduce it. Like, it just kind of a status quo bias, I would argue. So yeah, from that perspective, Qualia Research Institute and myself were very pleasure positive. It's like, no, actually pleasure is good.